Hey, do you have a digital-free chlorine sensor, Memosens CCS51D, in your disinfection process? Then you probably want to calibrate it someday, at least once a year after maintenance. But you're not really sure how to perform the DPD reference method correctly? Don't worry, you should be happy because you have found exactly the right video. I'm Theresa, the responsible service engineer for Endresenhauser's disinfection products, and I will show you now how easy it is to perform the slope calibration and adjustment of the free chlorine sensor CCS51D. If you're aware of the following tricks, then you're on the safe side and you will see DPD is not rocket science. May I present? This is the measuring point that I will calibrate now. You can see a Liquiline transmitter and our brand new FlowFit CYA27 multi-parameter assembly with a free chlorine and a pH sensor installed. Before you can start the calibration, there are some important preconditions that need to be fulfilled. Please check if the sensor reading is stable. It shouldn't drift. And with unsteady values, the sensor can't be calibrated neither. Same applies to the pH reading. If a pH calibration is required, this must be done beforehand, because as you know, free chlorine is pH dependent, and wrong pH measurement results in wrong chlorine values, no matter how perfectly you will perform your DPD reference test. If your sensor is still polarizing, the measuring values are not plausible. Hence, you have to wait until it's fully polarized, which is at least 60 minutes after installation or 30 minutes after maintenance. After this time, the sensor and the medium should have stabilized to the same temperature. And finally, the flow of the sample medium must be constant and within the correct range, because the free chlorine measurement is also flow dependent. This means it must be at least 30 liters in a standard CYA27 assembly or 5 liters in a reduced flow version. The fulfillment of this precondition is indicated by the flow switch and the status indication light. When you're thinking of other liquid analysis sensors, pH as the most famous, calibration often means making a measurement with your sensor in a reference medium, a buffer, or a standard solution. For disinfection, this is different. The sensor remains in the process and a sample is taken out. This sample must be analyzed offline according to the so-called DPD method, which is basically a colorimetric measurement done by a photometer. Therefore, I recommend the PF3 photometer from Macher Rhein-Nagel. It comes with its equipment in this handy case. Next to the photometer and the cuvettes, the DPD reagent is needed. There are different reagent kits available, and you should take care that you have the right kit in your case. They differ in their measuring range, the type of reagent, and the dosing. I personally recommend the powder pillows because they are very easy to handle. You will see. Now, before you prep the sample, please take care of yourself and put on chemical-resistant gloves and safety glasses. Now start with the serum measurement without reagent. The sampling valve of the assembly is perfect to take the sample from the same place as the online measurement. Ah, the red light reminds me of one tip that I almost forgot. For low flow conditions, activate the hold function. Then the transmitter will not generate an alarm. Okay, rinse the cuvette several times. And then fill in the blank sample. For the photometer measurement, the cuvette has to be very clean. No fingerprints on the outside or gas bubbles in the inside. insert the clean cuvette into the photometer and perform the serum measurement. Try to bring your DPD photometer close to the measuring point to perform your measurement as soon as possible after sample grabbing. Don't waste time, because the free chlorine concentration in the sample media will decrease constantly. Now start the calibration procedure at the liquid line transmitter. Therefore press Cal, Disinfection, Slope, Sample Calibration. Start the calibration and press OK. The transmitter checks that the stability criteria are fulfilled and stores the present value for the later adjustment. This is when you should take a second sample. And fill it into the emptied cuvette. Now it's getting serious. The actual DPD measurement begins. One last check. Take a look at the expiry date of the DPD reagent. Then fill the whole granules from the powder pillow in the cuvette. And mix it. The granules resolve easily. Therefore, just shake it slowly to prevent air bubbles. Caution again that there are no fingerprints or gas bubbles that could disturb the optical measurement. Insert the cuvette in the photometer and determine the chlorine concentration. You made it! After all, enter the value from the photometer into the liquid line. Thanks to the MemoSense technology, the calibration data is now stored in the sensor head, what allows you to use the sensor anywhere with its current adjustment. Another good thing about the MemoSense data is, whenever your DPD measurement failed and wrong calibration data is stored in the sensor, you're always able to restore the factory calibration. So it's foolproof. Now you really made it all. The adjustment is finished. Wasn't that easy? Thanks for watching. Follow Andres and Hauser to see more of our productions. And if this video was helpful, like it or leave a comment below. Thanks!